Due to its climate, the high desert area of Klamath Falls is a prime location to raise dairy cattle. Holland's Dairy continues a DeHoop family tradition that began in 1966. The cows here are Holsteins, and like their owner, they originated in Holland. Holsteins are the most productive dairy cow, and they are unique in that no two cows have matching color patterns. Today, these cows continue to provide quality milk to people around the West. We will follow a few of these newborns on our journey to adulthood. You will learn about what it takes to operate a dairy farm and how every effort is made to ensure that the cows are healthy so they produce wholesome, nutritious milk. After a calf is born, the mother cleans it off. This process releases the natural oxytocin in her brain. Oxytocin is the natural hormone that facilitates the flow of milk from the cow's udder during nursing. Sometimes human assistance is given to ensure the calf is born without injury. All of the cows are born here at the dairy. Because of health risk, no outside cattle are allowed on a farm. A newborn Holstein calf weighs about 100 pounds and can walk within 1 hour after birth. The newborn heifers, or females, stay here in the maternity ward a few hours where they are given their first immunization and tagged for record keeping. The male calves are sold after they are weaned from their mother. Once immunizations are complete, the heifers are moved to calf hutches where they are continually fed their mother's colostrum for the first 48 hours after birth. Colostrum is the first milk secreted at the time of birth. It contains special minerals, proteins, and antibodies that pass immunity traits to the calf. Eventually, the calf will begin drinking pasteurized milk that comes from a mixture of different cows. Pasteurized milk is the milk that has been heated to kill microorganisms which otherwise might cause disease. After the mother is given birth, she is fed an electrolyte fluid similar to a human sports drink. This drink helps to ensure hydration. She is also given a vitamin supplement to aid her in recovery after the stresses of birth. After she is fully recovered, she awaits milking. The calves continue to mature within the hutches. By 5 days age, they're introduced to a grain mixture and water. The grain they eat consists of rolled barley, corn, protein pellets, and molasses. This mixture is 18% protein. Protein is an essential nutrient for healthy growth and development. By 10 weeks of age, the weaning process begins. At 3 months of age, after the calves have been weaned, they are moved to another area on the farm. At this stage of life, the calves have their first introduction to a group setting. They now have access to an exercise lot where they're able to walk around and interact with others. Their food here is compiled into a mix of grasses, alfalfa, and grains called a total mixed ration. The rations are formulated by a nutritionist who visits the farm monthly. By having good nutrition and immunization programs, the calves are protected with strong immune systems. The first few months of a cow's life are the most critical. The behavior and habits learned in this time frame dictate how she will behave the rest of her life. The calves remain here for about 4 months. At this stage, they will develop all of the survival and social skills they need to move into the grazing area. At 14 months old, they are mature enough to be bred. The cows have a mating program similar to a human internet dating program. The traits of the cow are noted on a computer and then matched to a bull from a stud service with the best genetic traits. The cows are almost always artificially bred by the dairyman. The artificial insemination process is performed by gathering frozen bull semen and thawing it out for injection into the cows. You can probably guess what happens next. When a cow is in heat, the dairyman uses a plastic pipette to insert the semen inside her. No drugs or hormones are used to enhance the process. After the process is complete, the cow is moved back out to the pasture. A bull roams the territory in search of cows in heat. This is the backup plan to ensure pregnancy is successful. A cow must be a mother before she will produce milk, or as we say, freshen. To prepare the cows for milking, the teats are sanitized with an iodine mixture and in a small vacuum-operated milking unit is attached. These machines automatically milk the cow until her udder is empty. The milk leaves the cow's udder at about 101 degrees. On average, each cow produces up to 9 gallons of milk per day. The milk is pumped through a series of pipes where it is cooled down to about 35 degrees and is stored in large tanks. Each day around sunrise, the milk is collected by a large transport truck. The milk is sampled and tested before it's pumped into the truck. This ensures that it is still free from any contamination. Once the truck is filled, the driver seals the milk inside and then drives to a processing facility where it will be processed and sold to consumers. The cows stay in the barns between milking sessions where they are fed and watered. They are milked twice a day. The cows produce a lot of milk, but in order to produce 9 gallons a day, each cow must consume a balanced diet. Feeding this many adult cows requires special attention to ensure the food is filled with high-quality nutrients. When a Holstein cow is milking, she weighs between 1,100 and 1,500 pounds, so she is going to eat a lot of food to keep her 4 stomach compartments full. Each cow on a farm consumes about 50 pounds of feed per day. 24 pounds of hay, and 26 pounds of grain. The food available consists of a mixture of different foods. Dried peas, cotton seeds, and alfalfa hay are just a few of the ingredients. Food is measured and mixed into a large mixer that is pulled by a tractor. The feeder checks a chart to ensure proper ration mixing. He does this by weighing the food portions with a built-in scale. Then he adds molasses and water to the feed for consistency. On average, dairy cows produce milk for about 6 years. To make 9 gallons of milk a day, a cow must also drink 40 gallons of fresh, clean water. That's almost 4 gallons of water for every gallon of milk produced. Ultimately, producing milk for human consumption is why the dairy farm exists. People like to drink milk. Two ingredients found in dairy products make them healthy. Calcium, a major nutrient for humans that is necessary for strong bones and teeth, and vitamin D, a nutrient required by humans to produce healthy bones. So remember, without these gentle, pampered bovines, we wouldn't be able to enjoy a slice of their favorite cheese, a bowl of milky cereal, or even the cooling melt of ice cream on our tongues. This brings us to the end of our journey. Each newborn heifer on a farm will grow to adulthood and continue the process of providing your family with milk and other dairy products. We at Holland's Dairy hope that you have enjoyed learning about the life of a dairy cow and the processes of operating a dairy farm.